Hello, everyone. I'm going to be talking about a possible way for us to create a transition and how we can create a platform to organize ourselves in that direction. First of all, what I'm talking about regarding transition, I believe everybody here knows or has some notion of it. But just to be clear, I'm talking about moving from the isms, capitalism, socialism, Marxism, all the nine yards, and creating something that is based on abundance. Those systems, that for them to work, they need resources to be scarce. And the main question here is, can we do something actively to do that change? Instead of waiting other players, instead of waiting for things to happen so we can move forward. I first started by checking some of the initiatives that are around the globe, so maybe I could help them out or something like that. And eventually what I came about was either they were more focused on personal or local necessities, which is fine, or they lacked some strategy regarding creating things that can be recursively implemented or talk broadly about how more people can engage. And pretty much was the main components there were the transition itself can be extremely difficult to do because all the components are extremely complex and it's pretty hard for us to determine what pushes what inside this entire chain. And the other thing is, how can we own a possible transition? How can we actively go after all these components? So I just started asking very basic questions and trying to tackle the problem on its entirety. The first focus was behavior. We understand that behavior need to change, the culture, the values. The second thing was people need to live better inside this transition. So we need to tackle also everything that was regarding about tangible benefits. Also, a key component was motivation, but not a, motivation in the way that academics see it or discuss it, but how we as a society, as a civilization, understand motivation. And also to strategize those three components in an actionable way. So behavior, we found out that behavior needs to change first because technology doesn't drive behavior change on its own. So every time you give technology to someone, they must be educated about that, otherwise they're going to make things bad, or they're just going to perpetuate their behavior using that technology specifically. The motivation part was trying to reach as many people as possible, how we could implement something that could drive people to want a transition. And to strategize it so it can grow exponentially, so it have a life of its own, so it doesn't depend on initiative like ours or anyone else. The vast majority of people with low to mid income want their reality to change. That's something that is almost common information there. Whoops, what the hell did I do here? Okay, yeah, there's a red cross going back and forth here. I don't know how to raise that though. I don't want to screw things up. The higher income minority can be interested in informing themselves. This is something else that we've managed to find out. And people make time to the things that benefit themselves. So if you ask people to help someone else, some people love to do that, but it's a very tiny niche. But usually people make time to do things for themselves. Like if this improves my life, yeah, I can make time to do that. Oh, great. Another thing is the communication that we should derive from that was in a way that everybody could understand it, but never lose focus on technical aspects so information can be sent across the board without any misconceptions. And of course, trying to do that as best as possible and trying to reach as much people as possible, as many people as possible. So eventually we came up with the IDETRA initiative. And the first thing is about the reach. This should be a website, so you can reach as many people as possible. This is a platform that should look like anything that people use nowadays in social media and educational platform, free or paid. Should be quick to navigate and should inform people. For this, we created an entire area for educational purposes. And only after they go through all the 9 modules there, then they can access the blueprints part. And blueprints, you have solutions so you can implement yourself in your home. And by doing that, if everybody does this, we would be driving locally all the transitional aspects that we were discussing. And also trying to use social media as a place for people who are struggling with their own value change to just galvanize that and make sure that people have a place to go when things get tough. I think this is not working anymore. Oops, there you go. The educational platform consists basically on talking to people about psychology, biology, nonviolent communication, fallacies, critical thinking, scientific processes. So they know about those things, they can apply that into our day-to-day lives. So it's not a university, it's not a faculty, it's not something like that. It's just a way for people to be better informed on things that usually we learn way down the line, and we should have learned about those things when we were kids, and we don't. Whenever someone feels lost in one of the courses, I call it courses for lack of a better term here, we're going to have a third party outside of the platform links for basic information, and also if someone wants to drill down information regarding one specific topic, we are going to also have links there for advanced knowledge in, under that particular area. And the blueprints are tangible solutions despite where you live, if you live in a small apartment or a big house, and despite your income. If you don't have virtually any income, or if you are rich, you're going to find solutions at the blueprint area there. So it doesn't matter where you fall under this graph here, you will be able to find solutions in the blueprint so you can better yourself. Our main focus here is for you to create and produce and automate, if possible, food production, water production, and electrical energy production. But of course, we have more solutions regarding our other aspects there as well. Yep. There you go. Another thing that we are developing, and it's going to be live in the next couple of weeks, is the CI platform, the Center of Intelligence. This is a key component for the project. And what you have here is a platform for project management. So this is pretty important because how we organize ourselves, how we can create things, how we can move forward needs to be extremely well organized and in a fashion that we can communicate better and move into one specific direction instead of just going around circles and trying to figure out some of this stuff. So there are already outside in the world a lot of best practices regarding how to do that, and we should definitely use those best practices. So the platform, the CI platform, is as simple as we possibly can do that inside the project, but yet extremely, extremely powerful. So usually people like to see tangible things. I've been talking about website, I've been talking about initiatives. So regarding that, we are creating a prototype or just implementing some of these stuff in a house in São Paulo, Brazil, where we can show people what we are doing regarding better improvement of life. They are not new stuff, but they are aligned with the aspect of trying to create things without money or recycle materials or as much as possible. So just wanted to show you a couple of things that we have developed throughout our research phase here, and we're still doing some of this stuff. The first thing is this electric bike. After 4 to 5 years, the battery dies because it's their lifespan. And we decided to just grab notebook batteries and try to recreate the battery. So it's pretty much grabbing these out of the trash, opening them up, and getting out these lithium batteries right here. And usually you get like 6 per pack, and roughly 4 of them are extremely well. They are in very good conditions. So you just have to create a little. I know it looks extremely complex, but it's not. Just to test the batteries out, and then grab a whole bunch. And what we did was recreate the battery there. This bike is faster than it was, and this battery pack has been working for 2 years now. There you go. Another thing that we wanted to try out was automating the production of food. So what we did was figuring out how to use Arduino to control everything. It's a very cheap component that you can buy online and everywhere in the world, and use some of those components to just control the environment. And we wanted to do a very tiny prototype thing and make sure that, there you go, make sure that everything worked in a small container. So we did PET bottles and the Arduino with some water already, with some fertilizer there. And this is the first stage of the project. Then we managed to get everything working into one unit. And that's the final product, even with light. So you can control the light intake of the system. So it irrigates on a specific day and time when the humidity goes low or when the earth is dry. It drops some water there and all the 9 yards. Where do we point it? The grid solar panel is pretty much, that's the most expensive thing, because you can actually use LED light to generate electricity, but they have a very high, low yield of amperage. And so solar panels are still the way to go, although people are not throwing that away, like, because it's a new technology. I've seen a couple of cases where people are just switching solar panels, and you can find it in the trash, but still not very popular, not very common. And for a grid tie that you produce, you produce energy, and you send it to the place where it provides you energy by day, and by night you consume energy from them. So what happens there is you try to get a zero-sum game and not pay your bill. This is the internal a panel, so you can see what you're producing. There is the panel for your the company. And those are the guys that helped me out installing specifically, because in Brazil, legally, you must have an engineer, electrical engineer, signing up the project. So I couldn't do that on my own. This is a biodigester, again, extremely simple, extremely cheap to generate, to create. And the byproduct there is just like, after you eat something, just throw in inside the biodigester, and it comes out methane, so you can cook, and fertilizer production, so you can produce more food. This is the arrangement in the backside. Looks a little bit complicated, but it has two filters and a gasometer, So you can store the gas there, and you have a compressor that's from an air conditioner that someone threw in the trash, and but the compressor was working just fine. Also, vertical farming for small spaces. This was just a test run. We managed to make it work, and was right on the outside, so we could test if it could hold up rain and wind and stuff like that, and it did. So it was a very successful test run. Over here, you only have broomsticks and PET bottles. There's no nails, there's nothing metallic. You can do that structure-wise, everything only with broomsticks and PET bottles. And we start growing some stuff there for the test run, and the birds start eating the crop. So now we are creating a dome. We could have done that more squarely in a more standard fashion, but I thought it'd be interesting to have something more complex there. And we just created a geodesic dome, again using broomsticks and PET bottles alone. And as you can see, we're in the middle of creating it. You only have like those five steps there in the middle, but I still have to place more 30 with phases there and with different heights. To know where I point this so it goes. There you go. At this point, we need to finish the food production. The water production and rain collection is something that we also need to do. The solar heater to replace the electric shower is very important, so that grid-tie solar panel can actually work producing the energy that we consume inside the house. And I usually am the guinea pig of my own initiatives. So I'm going to live based on that for 6 months as soon as this first phase is done. And by those 6 months, I'm going to keep on improving and automating, generating more solutions. And also probably going to have like those YouTube diaries saying that I'm fine, I'm not dead, I can eat what I'm producing, so on and so forth. People are usually interested in that kind of stuff. And also there are more different types of products and projects that we have. And some of them were postponed because we didn't have enough hands there to help, or they were not initiated because it was like that on the roadmap. I'd like to invite you guys to check IDETRA.org. The website is not done completely, but in the next 10 days, we're going to have the CI platform up and running. I tried to make it make it running to the event, but I couldn't. You can try to do the registry there, but the problem is, eventually, while we're in this development phase, what happens is sometimes you have to destroy the database because we have a new implementation going. In this case, I grab all the users that are already in the platform and just contact them directly saying, yeah, we needed to do this, so you have to go there and re-register. We have the EDU part done, but not with the content. The courses are not there, although we have the syllabus ready because it involves video producing, it involves a lot of discussion and the quiz generation, so it takes a lot of time. And we don't have that many hands at this point volunteering for the project. And of course, everything is free. And I'd like to leave you guys with a quote from someone called Aaron Schwartz. He's an American guy. He allegedly committed suicide when he was 20-something. He was behind the Reddit, the RSS feed, the campaign against SOPA and PIPA. And apparently he was being harassed by the FBI because he wanted to get scientific knowledge out there and make public information public, which in the United States can be very tricky. So this this thought is attributed to him, and I think it's extremely powerful. And just ask yourselves constantly, what is the most important thing you could be doing and working in the world right now?
Come on, you can do it.
And if you're not working on that, then why aren't you? So I'd like to thank you guys for listening to me. You can reach me directly on this email, iditra@iditra.org. And that's it. Thank you, guys.